All right, guys, I know that, I guess you all know, we have so many audience here. So whatever extra, like you will be speaking with your parents or with your siblings, you need to mute yourself, right? And then speak. No unnecessary voices, please. I hope you all are grown enough. You can handle that much. Otherwise, I need to restrict everyone. Not to, like you should not be able to unmute yourself. All right, I'm just waiting for a few more participants to join in, then we'll start. Can I get a thumbs up that if you have downloaded the PictoBlock software? Has anyone downloaded the software? No, okay, fine. No issues, we can use it as an open source. We can use it online. Just waiting for a few more participants to join. And we'll start.
Good morning, everyone.
Hi, good morning, Savita ma'am.
Good morning, dear students. Pritika ma'am and dear students, good morning to everyone.
Yeah, actually they are muted. So you can just okay. See their hi. They won't be able okay. to speak
okay.
anything.
Okay.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, dear. Good morning. So I think meanwhile, I'll just give some little bit introduction.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Right, and then we can start.
Sure.
Till 71 are there. Okay. Good morning, all. This era is an era of modern technology that succumbs the world to globalization. We have to meet up with the existing standard, and for that reason, training the young generation is a must to holistically develop our students for better products. According to New Education Policy 2020, coding is a basic literacy in the digital age, and it's important for the kids to understand and be able to innovate with the technology around them. Go Global Base is an education initiative that endeavors to be a second home to kids. They have pioneered a unique approach to teaching by conducting online programs, live and in small, interactive groups of students. Go Global Base is an online platform for kids of the age group 7 to 14. In the 21st century, success is no longer about what to think. To stand out and win in the highly competitive world, you all have to learn how to think. This, however, is not what they will learn under ordinary conventional education system. STEAM education simply focuses on educate to innovate. Go Global, in association with Mount Carmel School, will be conducting a 3-day coding webinar for various classes. We welcome Ms. Kritika Verma, their program manager, to guide us through this interesting journey. But before we start, we would request all our participants to maintain decorum and raise hands whenever they have queries. So now we welcome Kritika. Over to you, dear.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for such a warm welcome. And it's a pleasure, like, to spend the morning with the young minds here. So hi, good morning, everyone. I hope you all now know my name. I am Kritika and I am from Go Global Base. So like as ma'am said, that coding is very important. We should know, we should be learning coding. It's a language for future, language for automation. So what is coding according to you? I guess like unmute yourself, everyone. Yeah, unmute yourself and one by one you guys can speak. I hope you all know how to maintain the decorum in the class. Yeah, what is coding? Yeah, Tanvi.
A coding.
Yeah. Are you speaking something? I guess Tanvi, we can't hear you. Yeah, yes, Radhya.
To command a sprite.
To command a sprite, right? What else? Yeah, Akshaya. 4D, roll number 15, I guess.
Coding is a language.
Coding is a language, okay. Like we are talking, we are using English language. So will that come under coding? So coding is language is an incomplete definition. Not all languages comes under coding. What kind of languages comes under coding?
Ma'am, computer language.
Computer language is perfect. And what kind of languages the computer understands?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ma'am, Java.
Digital language.
Coding is a language.
Ma'am, programming language.
Okay, okay, all right. All right, all right. I guess you all know what is a coding, right? It's a programming language. Perfect. So basically, like you guys are saying it's a computer language. Is it the correct answer? How do we know the computer language? We only know our human languages.
Ma'am, it's 1 and 0.
1 and 0, binary, correct.
Ma'am, by giving them a command.
Yeah, correct. Actually, coding is not a computer language. It is the conversion of our human languages to a computer language so that we can understand our language, what are we commanding, and computer can understand in its language what commands it is receiving. Coding is a translation of human languages to computer or machine language. Am I clear? All right. My next question is why there is a need to learn coding? Why you all want to be a coders?
Ma'am, so that we can make games and apps.
You guys can make games and apps. Okay, what else?
To invent new things.
To invent new things. Nice. What else?
Software.
Secret software. You can make your own.
Animation.
Designing.
Correct, correct. So you, like, basically coding is a magic. You guys can make anything with it. Can we say that?
Ma'am, we can send secret messages also.
We can send secret messages. Yeah, that is very important these days.
Good morning, ma'am.
Hi, good morning. Good morning.
Ma'am, we can talk to computer.
You can talk to computer. Nice. But while giving any instruction, you should be very specific.
Sentences.
Correct. You guys can do so lot of things using a computer language if you know, right? So I guess, I believe all the participants are here, might be some may join late. So I guess we can begin. All right. So the lockdown period is going on, right? What all kinds of things you do? You might be watching TV, you might be watching cartoons, you might be playing games. Of course, school classes are going on, school homework is there, right? But the games that you play on the mobile phone or the apps that you use on the mobile phone, they might be designed by someone, right? Right now, what you are doing, you are just downloading it from the Play Store and using it. Have you ever given a thought how these games are designed and how would it be if you could design your own?
Ma'am, they are designed from coding.
They are designed from coding.
Game.
You want to design your own game?
No, I have not designed it.
Ma'am,
I learned a little coding in this lockdown period, so I made few projects.
Perfect. You guys are using your lockdown productively. Very nice.
Ma'am, I make a game on scratch.
Made a game on scratch. Very nice. All right, so you guys might have done coding, some might be new to coding. So today we will be making a game, right? We will be making a game, we will be understanding the logic behind it. Okay, right? What commands do we need to give and how we can translate it so that a computer can also understand, a machine can also understand. We'll understand the logic of each and every block and hence we'll make a game. So shall we start? Today our section will be divided into two. In the first half, we will be designing a small game. In the second half, we will be designing a small object, a 3D object. Right? So what is 3D and what are 3D objects? That we'll discuss later when we start with it. Right? So let's focus on game design first. So I'm attaching a link, guys, on the chat. One second. Those who have downloaded Pictoblocks can open the downloaded version. Those who have not, I'm attaching a link for them.
Hello. Pictoblocks.
Yeah, Pictoblocks. Pictoblocks is similar as that of Scratch. It's just the extended version of Scratch. You can find the additional blocks here. It's the extension of Scratch, you may say.
The first Chrome say.
We have to download Pictograph.
No, don't download. If you have not downloaded, don't download. I'm attaching something on the chat, guys. See if you have received any link. Open that.
Yes, ma'am, we received the link.
Open it. It will directly take you to Pictoblocks. No need to download it. Those who have downloaded can open the downloaded version, your choice. So if you open it, you can like resemble it more and less similar to that of Scratch, right? But it have few additional blocks, few additional sprites, few additional backgrounds.
Ma'am, it opens in the Play Store only.
Right.
But it is like Scratch only.
Yeah, it is like Scratch only. That's what I'm saying. But a little advanced version.
And the sprite is Toby.
Yeah, the sprite is Toby. Okay, let me share my screen, guys. Okay, see if my screen is visible to all.
Blocks.
Is it okay? Perfect. So what additional features are there? I am telling you that you all have done Scratch, so I'm skipping the basics. I'm quickly briefing you the interface of the software. So here you will find all the blocks.
Ma'am, I have not done Scratch.
Okay, so I'm starting from the basics only. Let me explain you how the software is.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
When we are on our software, we cannot see you on Zoom.
No, right now we are not doing anything on your software. You guys leave your software and come here on Zoom.
Okay. Ek baar dijiyega.
Come here on Zoom, everyone. So here on the left hand side, you will find all the blocks which can help. Guys, let me complete myself. I'll take the doubts later. Or you can drop your queries on the chat. I'll address it later. So here on the left hand side, you will find the colorful blocks. These all blocks will help you to give commands, to prepare a script, to prepare a code for your sprite. Like the first is move block, so it will help your sprite to move. The second is turn block, it will help your sprite to turn. So each and every block is there to help you work. What kind of commands you want to give to your sprite? All right. Now the center area is the workspace. This white area is the workspace. This is your working area. You may say it as a notebook. You can perform your scripts here. You will be writing your scripts here. You will be writing your codes here. You just need to drag and drop the block and place it here. This is your workspace. Here you will be working. Now this space where your sprite is standing, that is your stage. This is known as stage, and this character is known as sprite. So in four sections, your Pictoblocks software is divided. Now let's say I don't want this sprite. I want to delete it. So that delete button you will find here. Your sprite is selected. You can see a purple color square around it. Your sprite is selected. You will find a dustbin with a cross sign. If you click on that, your sprite will be deleted. Now, how to get a new sprite? There is a purple color circle here on the bottom right side, on which we have, I guess, a panda face. So if you click on that, that is your entire sprite library. You can choose any sprite from there. many are there, some might be of scratch, few are additional as well. So from here you may choose any sprite. Even if you think your and like you the sprite you want is not there in the list, you can paint your own sprite. If you are a good painter, you can paint your own sprite. You can draw it, you can color it as per your choice. Otherwise you can get it from Google. You can download any image from Google and we can use that image here as a sprite. So all the freedom you have, there is no restriction that if the sprite is not there in the list, so you can't use it. It's nothing like that. You can draw, you can get it from the Google, or you can choose from this library. Now, if I choose any sprite, see the background is white, which might be very boring. So what we can do, we can get a background as well. Just to the right of this purple color circle, we have one more circle, which is asking you to choose a backdrop. So if you click on that, you can pick any backdrop from there of your own choice. Same goes with the backdrop. If any background is not there in the list, you can either paint it or you can get it from the Google. You can get the image, download the image from the Google and get it here. So that was the introduction of the software. I hope I'm clear till here. Can I get a thumbs up? All right, so that was the introduction of PictoBlocks, the basic PictoBlocks. Now let me tell you how it is different from Scratch. If you go to add extension here, click on add extension, a purple color box on the bottom left side of your software. These are the additional blocks we have: face detection, object detection, human body, machine learning, artificial intelligence, NLP. These all are the new blocks here. Like you can extend your Scratch with PictoBlocks. How? By adding the artificial intelligence and machine learning. I hope you all are aware of AI, right? AI is in these days. And what is AI? You can directly interact with your machine. Live interaction can be there with your machine. Like Alexa. Alexa can hear you and it hence gives you the required or desired result. So how that machine is able to listen your words, identify your words, that is artificial intelligence. So such kind of projects you guys can make here in PictoBlocks. That is one extension. The second is you can even control robots with it. Like we humans, we have brain. So what is the brain of the robot? It is a microcontroller. And these all kind of microcontrollers PictoBlocks allows. So you can even control your robots. Like Lego, I guess Lego you might all have heard. It's a very famous robotics kit. Lego you all have heard. Lego robots, Arduino, Evive, Quirky, these all are the microcontrollers, the brain of the robots which you can control here. So you can make your hardware also compatible with PictoBlocks. So these two are the extended version here. So now you all know what's the difference between a Scratch and a PictoBlocks. So are we good to start now? Shall we start our game? All right. So whatever queries you are having, you can drop on the chat. I won't be able to unmute yourself, right? I won't be able to unmute you guys during the session. So once my lecture is over, you guys, I'll give you that freedom. Then we can have a question answer rounds or doubt rounds. I'll try to go slow so that there won't be any doubt rising. All right, so what are we making? We are making a maze game, a simple and easy maze game. So what I'm doing, guys, if you go to the background list, we already have a maze background, this yellow one. You don't need to paint your maze. You don't need to get it from the Google. We already have a maze. Take that. Click on it. It will come. It will appear on the screen. And sprite is totally your choice. You may pick any sprite you want. Like for example, I am taking a beetle. And adjust the size of your sprite. Size option you will find here. There are few numbers written below your stage. One of the number is size, where 100 is written. 100 is the by default size. Size you can adjust. And bring your beetle at the start position from where you would like to start the game. So my final stage looks like this. A maze apple is already there in the maze. I have taken that beetle. I adjusted the size to 50.5%, and like that's my starting position of the beetle. So I'm taking a pause here of a minute. You guys prepare your stage. Give me a thumbs up once you all are done. I'm getting a query how to draw a sprite. Here, actually, in this game, we don't need to draw. You can pick anything from the list. Otherwise, how will you draw? Just hold the cursor here from where we chose the sprite. Just hold, don't click it. If you click it, the list will open. Just hold the cursor there. There is a paint brush in the list. Paint is the option. If you click on that, a paint editor will open, a paint window will open. There you can paint. Circle tool is there, just paint anything random so it will appear as a sprite. Anything you can paint. So this is a sprite now. I can use it as a sprite. That's how you can paint. But painting is not required here. So shall we start with the coding? Those who have joined late, there is a link in the chat. I am attaching it again. Size of the beetle can be anything. Size is totally your choice. I have taken 50. There is a link in the chat. Those who have joined late, please open that link. If you click on that link, it will directly take you to the software that we are using. You can choose any sprite you want. Any background will be common. Background, the maze only, the maze game we are making. Background is common for all. Sprite, you may choose any. Just make sure whatever sprite you are choosing, it should come between the lines. So size you need to adjust. Because we will be making a game in which if it touches the black lines, the game will be over. So try to like reduce the size of your sprite so that it comes in between the lines. Whatever sprite you are taking, you are free to choose that. So I guess it's enough time now. Your stage might be prepared. Whatever queries you are have, we have another team member in the like meeting, he will be addressing. All right, so let's start with the coding. So guys, whenever you make a game, you might have observed it, always start with a button. We always have a start button to start our game, is it? We always have a start button. So here you have just above your background, you can find a green color flag. That is your go button. So whatever games you are making, like here we are making a maze game, so we can use that go button. If we click that go, our game will start. Let's do that. So the start buttons are known as events. Go to events on the right hand side, the yellow color category is events. Go to events, everyone. And we have a block there, the first one, when flag clicked. When flag click means when you will be clicking the flag, then what should happen? Events are the hat blocks, like hat we always wear on the top. So events are usually used on the top only. With events only your code starts. Now, I guess we all want to move this beetle with the arrow keys on the keyboard, right? With up arrow it should go up, with left it should go left, right and down. I guess we all want the same. Now, how will the beetle comes to know that which button is being pressed from the keyboard? How can it come to know? So now there is a time the beetle needs to sense. I hope you all know what are sense organs, right? Like we human bodies, in our human bodies, we have 5 sense organs. There are 5 sense organs in our human body. Why do we need them? Basically to communicate with the external environment. All the sense organs are important to sense the obstacles, to sense the temperature, or to sense various things. Similarly, your machines, your laptop, computer, mobile phones, your robot, your drones, all the machines have sensors, right? So here also, how the beetle will come to know that which button is being pressed from the keyboard, because beetle is inside the, like it's just an image inside the computer. So now we need to make it sense. I'm sharing my screen again. There is a light blue color circle, a category on the left hand side saying sensing. Click on that. There is a block here, key space pressed. And here you will find all the keyboard buttons. So put it separate right now. I'll tell you where we are attaching it. Just put it separate. Key space pressed. Since we are having 4 arrow keys and we want to use them all, we will be taking 4 of these out. And change 1 to up arrow, change 1 to down, 1 to left, and 1 to right. These 4 sensors we need for the beetle. I'm taking a minute pause here. You guys can, like, if you are unable to switch in between the screens, you guys come on Zoom, see my screen, go back to your software. That's what you can do. I'm taking a minute pause here. Till the time I can read the chats. Okay, some are saying done. Ma'am can't open, but what exactly you can't open? Link is clickable, everyone is using the link only. Dhruv, you may write your concern, like what help do I need to do? Okay, I'm starting the explanation again. You guys will go to the library. How will you come on to the background library? There is a purple colored circle on the bottom right side. Click on that. It's saying choose a backdrop. So this screen will open. What I'm showing you on Zoom. A maze background is already there. The first one in the second row. Otherwise, there is a search box on the top. You can search for maze. So I have taken this maze background. Sprite, you can choose either sprite you want. Any sprite you want, you can choose. Adjust the size accordingly so that it comes in between the lines. Because later, once the coding like proceed, we will be doing that. If it touches the black line, the game should over. So try to reduce the size of the sprite so that it comes in between the lines. Any sprite you can choose. Now to decide the start button, we are taking this flag. The flag button, the go button, you can find just above your stage. Just above your backdrop, there is a flag button, the go button. Start buttons you will always find in events, the yellow color circle category. Go to that. The very first block is when flag clicked. This software is color oriented. So whatever block I'm using, you can match the color. So that block I might have taken from that. It's colorful like software for the kids to like start coding. So when flag is clicked, then what should happen? I want beetle should start sensing what button is being pressed on the keyboard. So there is a sensing category and there is a block key space pressed. I have taken 4 of them out. Right now they are separate. I'll tell you where to attach them. So key space press, take 4 of them out, change 1 to up arrow, 1 to down, 1 to left, 1 to right. You may use even alphabets. That's your choice with what controls you want to make your beetle move. That's again your choice. I'm using arrow keys. In the drop down, you have all the buttons of the keyboard. So totally it's your choice. All right. Now, I guess I can proceed further. So there is a condition now. If I press up arrow, then only it should go up. If I press down arrow, then only it should come down. Is it? Right? We have conditions now. If I press up, now where we can find those conditional statements? In control. Go to control, guys. See what is the fourth block there. You can find if then. So since we have four conditions, we will take four if thens out, one below another. One if then will not go inside another if then, guys. Please make sure that if thens will be one below another. If where one if then is closing, the another if then will start. If thens won't go inside one another. Now you can see in between if and then, we have a diamond shape, a hexagon shape block. And all your sensing blocks, what we have taken out, the blue ones, they are also hexagon in shape. So that means they need to go inside like this. Now my conditions are complete. If key up arrow press, then. If key down arrow press, then what will happen? If key left arrow, if key right arrow. Now my conditions are complete. I'm taking a pause here. You guys complete till here. So if, as we all know, it is a conditional statement. If you study, then only you will get a good mark. So if the condition is true, then only the output will be true. Are we all done till here? Can I get a thumbs up? I guess maximum students have done. I'm sharing my screen again so that you guys can look into the coding and complete. We have done till here. I'm making my stage a little small so that I can increase the coding size if you want. I'm zooming it a little. All right. So let's proceed. So guys, what you want, we have four conditions, right? Four if thens we have. So what we want, will these four conditions be applied throughout the game? Or just once in the beginning only? Will the beetle be sensing throughout the game all these conditions or only in the beginning? What do you think? The beetle will be sensing all these four conditions throughout the game, right? Whenever we are pressing up arrow, whenever we are pressing any of the arrow keys, it should sense. It should not be like just in the beginning it is sensing and then it stop in the middle of the maze. It should not be the case. Continuously throughout the game it should sense. So what we'll do, go to control. See what is the third block there? It's saying forever. I hope you all know what's the meaning of forever. Hamesha. It will keep on doing the task continuously until and unless you are not stopping it. So that is the block we need. All these four conditions will go inside forever. Take a forever and drag all the four conditions inside like this and attach it with the flag. So this should be the final look of your coding. You guys can match your code with mine. See if something is left. Okay, some students are asking the link. I am attaching it again. Okay, are we all done till here? Now, with the arrow keys, your sprite will be moving. Now comes the movement of the sprite. How will the beetle go forward, backward, left, right? So all the movement blocks, guys, you will find in motion. Go to motion. The first one. Motion means movement. That you will study in science. Motion means movement. So in the motion block, you will find all the movement blocks. Now with the up and down arrow, your beetle will be going vertically up and down. And with the left and right, your beetle will be going horizontally left and right. So I hope you guys know what's the difference between a 2D and a 3D. 2D and 3D, everybody knows the difference. So like this beetle, it is a 2D image, right? This is a image of the beetle. It's not the real beetle. I can just see the front side of the beetle. I can't see it from the back, left or right. I can just see the top view. This is called 2D. It's not a real image. It's just a 2D object. So 2D comes with two dimensions, X and Y. Your X is horizontal. Your Y is vertical. Some of you, I guess, might have learned graphs. I'm not sure if the graphs is there in your course or not. So just remember this much. This is a 2D platform. TiktoBlocks is a 2D platform. So two dimensions are there. 2D, the full form is two dimensions. One dimension is the horizontal X and the vertical. The another one is Y. X is horizontal, Y is vertical. That you need to remember. Okay. Now with up and down, we will be changing Y because Y is the vertical axis. With left and right, we will be changing X, the horizontal axis. So in motion, guys, if you scroll down a little, you will find change X by 10 and change Y by 10. So Y you use with up and down and X you use with left and right. So your code should look like this. With up and down, use Y. With left and right, use X. Now, if up arrow is change Y by 10, down should go in the opposite direction. So make your down arrow minus 10. If up arrow is plus 10, change Y by 10, down arrow will be change Y by minus 10 so that it can go in the opposite direction. And left arrow, right arrow, if it is change X by 10, then left arrow will be change X by minus 10 so that it can go in the opposite direction of right. Now your controls are done. Press your flag and use your arrow keys on the keyboard. See, my beetle has started moving. In all the four directions, it is moving. You guys can try. It won't sense the black lines. Nothing will happen with the black lines because we have not done that coding. We have only done the coding for the arrow keys. Press your flag and check. Is it moving fine? I hope the codes, the blocks we have used, in what sequence we have used, is that clear? Now let me know. Give me a thumbs up if your beetle is moving up, down, left, right. I am giving you the controls to unmute yourself, but please speak one by one.
Ma'am, can you?
Ma'am, no.
Okay.
Ma'am, is from the
country.
Okay, I'm sharing my screen again. Match your coding with this. With down arrow, make sure it is minus 10. With left arrow, it is minus 10. The signs, the symbols are important to make it go in the other direction. Now, last two conditions are left. If the beetle touches the black line, what will happen? And if the beetle touches the apple, what will happen? Two things are left, then your game is complete. Guys, make sure with up arrow, it should be changed Y by plus 10. With down arrow, it should be changed Y by minus 10. Check the numbers also. With left arrow, it should be changed X by minus 10. With right arrow, it should be changed X by plus 10. Check the numbers, please. The signs are important to make it go in the opposite direction. So now two more conditions are left. If the beetle is touching the black color, what will happen? And if the beetle is touching the apple, what will happen? Now let's proceed with the black color first. Now again, the beetle needs to sense that it is touching the black color. It needs to sense whenever it is touching, the same thing should happen. The game should end. Okay. Now, again, something in sensing you will find. Go to sensing. There is a second block touching color. Because this time it will be sensing the colors. Put it separate somewhere. I'll tell you where to attach it. Put it separate. Touching color. Now, click on that color because we need to match that color with the black color. Click that color. Now, where will you find the black color? You guys will say in the third slider of brightness, take the slider to the left side. But that is not the answer. We can never find our color exact from the slider. Because as you guys know, the color comes with variation. It can be light black, it can be dark black. We don't know, right? What is the exact color of the maze lines? We don't know which black it is. It is dark, it is light, it is medium. We don't know. Every color comes with a variation. So whenever you are using touching color block, you guys will never use these sliders which are coming over here. Now, how will you get your black color here? Guys, see that carefully. Because if the color didn't match, your beetle won't sense. You may leave your picto blocks and come here on Zoom. See, touching color block, I guess you all have taken out. Now, how will you match this color with the black color? you click on that color, we won't be choosing the color from these three sliders. Just below the third slider, you have a pick color tool. Click on that, your stage will be highlighted. Now take your cursor. In your cursor, a center square should be on the color you want. I want black, so I'll take black. I'll click on that, my black color will come here. So this is my exact black color. From the slider, I can't sense which color it is. I hope I'm clear. Go to sensing, take the second block touching color, bring it out in the workspace, don't attach it anywhere, put it separate, bring it out in the workspace, click on the color, three sliders will open. No, don't choose your color from the slider. Just below the third slider, you have a dropper kind of tool, the pick color tool. Click on that, your stage will be highlighted. Now your cursor will change to a circle with a dot inside. That inside dot should be on the exact color which you want. Click on that color, it will come on in your block. Someone is saying, I am not able to select motion. If you are not able to select motion, that means your sprite is not selected. Guys, see here on my screen, if my sprite is selected, then only the motion blocks will come. If your background is selected, motion will never come because background cannot move. Background cannot move, hence motion will not come. It's saying stage selected, no motion blocks. If you select your beetle, then only the motion blocks will come. Select your sprite, then only the motion blocks will come. If your stage is selected, the background is selected, motion will not come because stage cannot move. Only sprite can move. So I guess you got your color. This is another condition we have. If your beetle sends the black color, so that means we need one more if then. Go to control, take one more if then and put it inside the same forever. Take one more if then. If then, guys, as I told you, one below another they will come. One if then will not go inside another if then. So take this if then below the last four conditions were done for the mouse, for the keyboard. Four conditions were done, up, down, left, right. Now below that, the fifth if then will come. And touching color will go inside like this. So if touching color black, then what? You saying something, Chay?
I can't open the link and when I'm going to the Play Store, it's not showing.
On the Play Store, okay, you are using phone. On the Play Store also the app is there, PictoBlocks. App is there on the Play Store.
I am using my iPad. I have tried in my iPad.
Okay, on iPad it is not there. Okay, if you are I didn't know that you guys are some of you are using phones. I didn't know that. So what you can do, you just observe how the coding is going, right? Later you can try it on the laptop. On iPad it won't be possible. If you have an Android tablet, then it is.
In the phone it's possible or not?
Yeah. In the phone, if it is Android, it is possible. It is available on Play Store.
Okay, but I don't have Android phone.
So it will be tough then, either laptop or either Android phone. On iPad also soon it will be launching. But as of now, it is not there.
In laptop, I will try.
Sure. You understand the coding with us, later you can try on your own. All right, so if touching color black, then what? I guess the game should stop. The game is out, right? The game should stop. So the stop block in control, if you scroll down, you will find a block, stop all. everything will stop, the game will stop. Okay, someone is asking how to attach forever. Forever will come here. Just below flag, your forever will come. And everything, whatever conditions you are adding, it will go inside forever. Just below flag, first you attach your forever. And whatever conditions we have, it will go inside forever. Because all the conditions need to be sensed continuously throughout the game. Now, if you check, if I show you on full screen, if I move my beetle and let's say I'm touching this black line, so see the game is stopped. I can't move my beetle further. It is stopping with the black line. Sensing the black lines, it is stopping. So if you have taken the exact color, like I told you from the pick color tool, your beetle will sense and whatever block you are putting inside, it will work. We have added stop wall, so the game is stopping. Now the last condition is left, if beetle touching the apple. Again, we'll go to sensing because it needs to sense whenever the apple will come. Go to sensing. Again, you take the second block touching color, put it separate. Match your color with the red color from the pick color tool. Because we don't know what shade of red it is. Take the red color. I got my exact red here. I need another if then, because again, it is a condition. If it touches the red, then what? I'm taking it inside forever because again, it needs to be sensed continuously. If it touches the red, then a clapping sound. You can even add sounds. You have a sound library here on the top left side. You will find code costume sounds. If you go to sounds, one of the sound is there already, pop. But if you want to add some other sounds on the bottom left side, you will find a circle, choose a sound. Click on that. This is the entire sound library which will open. So many sounds are there. So I want a cheering sound or a clapping sound. So I have two cheer sounds. I'm using this one. You can pick any sounds you want. And if touching red color, it will play the sound cheer. And my game will stop again. I'm adding the stop all again. After giving the sound, the game will stop because I won. So that completes your game. Of course, you may add a few more flavors to this game. It can be a multiple level game. Let's say this is an easy maze. If it touches the apple, it can go to the next level, a little tough maze. Of course, you can add more varieties to it. This is the basic one that we have learned. Am I clear, guys? So you can save your project if you guys are done. Go to file and click on save. Save your project. So I hope we are all done with it. Shall I stop my screen share? Those who have not done, but at least I guess you have understood the coding, which block we have used and why we have used. We have used the sensing blocks, we have used the conditional statements, if then, and a forever loop and an event. Motion blocks, sounds, stop all the controls, these all blocks we used. And this is the very basic game that we have made. You guys can make shooting games, like fighting games or the whatever games you play. The maze games, ping pong, air hockey, all the games that you play. If they are in 2D, you guys can obviously create here. Only 2D games you can create, no 3D, only 2D games. Stories you can make, animations you can do, so many things you can do on PictoBlocks. So shall I stop my screen share? Now we'll move on to the 3D design part. How to add the sound? One of the question is there in the chat. So there is a sound library. You go to the sound here on the top right, top left side. We have a sounds category, code costume sounds. Click on sounds. One of the sound is there already, pop. See if that suits you to use. Otherwise, on the bottom left side, you will find a circle. Choose a sound. Click on that. Now from here, you can get any sound you want. So many are there. Put it in the search box. If you know the exact name of the sound, like cheer or clap or anything, you can write and take it. It will be selected. Then you come back to code. That sound will be appearing here in the magenta color category. I have the cheer sound. So that's all for the game design part. It was just a demo of the basic games, right? Now, what all kind of games you can play? Fruit Ninja, shooting games, fighting games, right? The puzzle games you can make. So many games are there. And of course, you guys play more games than me, right? So the ideas should be coming from you. What all kind of games you want to make? What all kind of flavors you want to add? All right? Now you guys can save this project. We are proceeding towards the next section, the 3D design. You guys may minimize or you guys can save your project and close the PictoBlocks because now we will be using a different software. You guys may unmute yourself. There is a general discussion first, what is 3D and all, and then we'll proceed forward with the software.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Okay. Guys, if there is any queries, any doubts, I will be sharing this video or the code file with you. I share the code with you. No issues in that. It is not working.
Ma'am, the title is not.
Okay, the link is not opening. That means you might be using
the game.
Excuse me, ma'am.
How
to save the game?
Guys, stop.
Ma'am, it is not going up and down.
Stop, guys. Okay. See, guys, if it is not going up and down, that means the blocks placement might not be correct by you. It will be very tough to take the doubts one by one. So what will I do? I'll share the code file with you. I'll share the screenshot of that code with you. You guys can then match. Each and every block is color oriented. You guys know from which color palette you will get that. Okay. The placement of the blocks might not be correct with you with the if it is not going up and down. So you with up arrow, you need to use change y by 10. With down arrow, it should be change y by minus 10. It will definitely go up and down. Some of the kids are done.
Excuse me, ma'am.
We are now going to the 3D designing part. So we have another trainer with us. Sarabjot, are you there?
Ma'am, I have done my project, but
ma'am, how to save it
also?
Correct, perfect.
Ma'am, how to save the project?
How to save the project? You will find the file option on the one by one. You will find the file option on the top left. Go to file, click on save as.
Save as is not coming. The option
might be coming.
No, new, load from your computer, save to your computer.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Save to your computer.
Okay, I have clicked. Now something file is opening, like downloads.
Yeah, so that means your project is saved on your system. It is downloaded on your system. You can use it anytime you want.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
All right, guys, now we are proceeding towards the next section. We are short with time. Again, like that part also will take time to make the, you need to make a project in that as well. So let's just skip this here. I'll share the code file with you. No worries in that. Now, Sarabjot, are you there? Another teacher will be taking you for the 3D design.
Hello, kids. Good morning. I hope all of you are safe and sound in your homes. So, like right now you have done a project or make design a game, like you have designed a 2D game. Now we will be working on 3D thing. Now, what is the basic difference what is the difference between 2D and 3D? Okay, so if you are if you know anyone knows, you can drop your answers in the chat box. I will check the answers in the chat box. So you guys can drop your answers in the chat box. What's the difference between 2D and 3D? Okay. You can only see the face of a 2D picture. You can see all the sides of 3D. Okay. Okay. And can you give me examples of 2D objects and 3D objects? In 2D, we can see 2D has no thickness. Very good. We can see also the width and height in 3D. Okay. Very good. It looks real. Okay. Circle. Circle is not 3D. Yeah, circle is a 2D. Okay. Okay. Cube is a 3D. Okay. Okay. Very good, guys. So I guess you all know the basic difference between 2D and 3D. So basically, 2D is the object which is having two dimensions, like length and breadth, or we can say length and width. And the 3D can be the object which is having three dimensions, like length, breadth, and height. Okay. So we will be designing the 3D things on a software like Tinkercad. Like right now you have worked on PictoBlock. So there is one more software like Tinkercad. I am sharing the link in the chat box. So you guys can quickly open that link. And I hope you guys have already made an account on Tinkercad. Okay, I have shared the link in the chat box. So you guys can quickly open this link. And also I am sharing my screen. Of Tinkercad. Okay. So if all of you have logged into the Tinkercad. If you have logged in, you just have to click on this sign in option. Okay. And from the sign in, you can. No. Okay. Those who have not logged in, open the link and you can sign into your account. Or if you have not made account, you can join now. You can click on join now. Start with the designing part. Let me just share my screen again. So when you will log into your account, your Tinkercad will look something like this. It will be showing you this dashboard where you can see your projects which you have done. And over here, it will show you different options, 3D designs, then circuits, and then code blocks. Okay, you can make 3D designs. You can make 3D designs and code blocks. You are using the code blocks also, and you can also work with the circuits in Tinkercad. So right now we will be designing a very simple skateboard. Okay, maybe you can, it is visible on your screen also. Let me just open it. I will just show you the glimpse of the project which we are going to do. Let me just refresh my Tinkercad. Everyone have opened the Tinkercad? Just drop your messages in the chat box if all of you have opened it. Okay. Okay, so like most of the students have Yes, yes, Tanvi, you can ask your question. You can drop your question in the chat box. We will resolve your query. Okay, so we will be making a skateboard like this, like it is visible on my screen. I hope it is clear, visible to you guys also. So we will be making this simple design of a skateboard. And whenever you have to design something, you just simply click on create new design and it will open a window. It will take few seconds to load. If anyone is having any query, just put your queries in the chat box. Yes, Tanvi, you can drop your message in the chat box if you are facing any difficulty. And if you are also having any doubt, you can just put your message in the chat box. Now, see, when you will open the Tinkercad, it will show you this screen. And over here, we have, this is the work plane where we will be designing our shapes. We will be designing our, like whatever you want to design, like you can design your fidget spinner. Like we will be designing a skateboard right now. You can design a pen stand, like number of things you can design over here. So this is the work plane. And likewise, I have said that we are working in 3D things. So you can move your work plane like this. You just have to simply right click on your mouse. And if you will drag your mouse, it will move like this. So you can see all the dimensions of your design. You can see the top view, bottom view. Okay. And there is one more way to move this work plane. On your screen, on the left-hand side of your screen, you will see this small box over here. In this box, you can see it is written front. If I will click on front, it will bring your work plane like this. From here, you can see the front view of your shape. Let me just show you by dragging a simple object. Okay, now this is a small box over here. I want to see all the sides of this box. So what I will do, if I will click on front, it will show me the front side of my box. And if I will move this box and click on top, it will show me the top view of the box. And similarly, I can see the left view. And then I will move it to right view. And also you can see the bottom view. Okay, so you can see all the views of your design, how it looks from other sides also. Like it is not like 2D, you can just see one face. In 3D, you can see all the faces, top view, bottom view, left view, right view. Okay, so what we will be doing is we will be designing a skateboard. And to design a skateboard, let me just first tell you how to edit the things, how to change the dimensions. Someone is raising hand. See, if you are having any doubt, any question regarding this, just simply put your message in the chat box. I will just check the chat box also side by side. Someone is not able to join. So see, you can open the link which I have shared, and from that link you can click on sign in and use your school ID to open the to join in. The procedure is already shared in the chat box. You can follow the steps to sign in into the skateboard. Your skateboard is not coming. We have to still design a skateboard that was visible on my screen because I have designed one before. We will design one skateboard right now. Yeah, email is like your, you have to use your school ID, like your school email ID. You can use that email ID to sign in. Okay, now look at the screen. When I have dragged this shape over here, when I will select this image, can you guys see these small boxes over here? Some of are in white color and some of are in black color. And also there is one black color cone on the top. Now, what are these dots and these cones are doing over here? So I have dragged the box. Now I want to change the dimension of this box. Now, how can we change this dimension is simply click on this white dot. Okay, simply click on this white dot. And if you will drag your mouse, you can change the dimension like in whatever direction you want to change like this. Like it will work in 3D direction or three dimensions. And other ways, you can just simply type the dimension, whatever dimension you want, just simply type it. And it can also change your dimension. And then there is this black dot over here. This black dot will change your dimension in one side only. Like if I will select this black dot, it will change the dimension in this direction only. You can't change it to left or right using this dot. If you want to change it to left or right, you have to select this black dot, like this. Okay. And then this black cone is, we can use this black cone when I want to lift my object from the ground. Like it will lift your shape or a image or this box which I have taken from the ground. Okay, if you want to lift your object from the ground, you have to use this black one. Okay, is it clear, everyone? These things are clear to you? Okay, chalo. We will start with our design, and side by side, I will tell you more new things how which are available in the Tinkercad. So first of all, drag your box to the workplace. Let me show you again how to drag it. In the shapes corner on the right hand side, select this box and drag it to the workplace. It is similar to the like you were dragging the blocks in the picture blocks. Just drag this. Now you have to drag this box to the workplace. Just show me the thumbs up when you have after dragging the box so that we can move forward. Drag this box to the workplace. Okay, now we have to change the dimensions of this white box because we are making a skateboard. So I want to increase its length. So I will click on this white dot and this dimension, I will make it 100 and the other one I will keep it as 20 only. So change the dimensions to 100 and 20. You can look at the screen and change the dimensions, make it 100 and 20. Just show me the thumbs up when you have changed the dimensions. Okay, now we have to change the height also. Our skateboard can't be this much, it can't be of this much height. Na? The skateboard's height is very less. So now click on this white box on the top and change its height to 5. Change its height to 5 or make it 2. 5 is also very thick, so make it 2. Yeah. So your dimensions are 100, length 100, width 20, and its height is 5. Is it done? Okay, I'm just quickly repeating the steps. Drag the box from the workplace and change its dimensions to 100. I am repeating steps. You guys don't have to repeat this step. Someone has asked me to repeat it. So I'm just quickly showing you how to change the dimensions. Change the dimensions to 120 and width to 5. Like this. You will get this shape. Oh, sorry. Change it to height to 2. Okay. Now, after this, select this box which we have taken, of which we have changed the dimensions. And on the right hand side, you may see different things written over here: radius, steps, length, width, and height. Now, what we have to do is we have to make the edges of our skateboard a little bit curvy. So, what we will do, we will use this slider of radius, and I will make its radius to, make it to 6. Change its radius to 6. Now, see, my skateboard will be looking like this. And in your case also, make it a little bit curvy. Change the radius to 6, or you can even increase the radius. It's up to you guys how much radius you want to keep. I have kept it as 6. Is it done? Okay, very good. Great. Now, the next thing is, now how are skateboards move? How are skateboards move? Just drop your answer in the chat box. How the skateboards move? Using wheels. Very good. Very good. Okay. So now we will design the wheel part of our skateboard. Now, again, take a box. Okay, one more thing. You can also change the color of your skateboard. Like from here, in the right-hand side, from where we have changed the radius of the skateboard, you can change the color also. Like when you will click on this color option, see, you can change the color from here. Like I will keep it as, I will choose this color. You can also change the color of your skateboard. Okay. Now, again, take one more box and its dimensions will be 10. Oh no, sorry, keep it as 20 only. 10 will be very small. We will use it as it is. It is change, keep its dimensions to 20 and height also 20. Okay, now what I need is I want to make a hole in this box. Any idea how can we make a hole in this? Yeah, you can draw, if you know the answer, you can drop your answers in the chat box simply. That's the easy way to communicate. Okay, very good, very good. I have got answer from Ayushman. Very good, Ayushman. We will add a sphere. Okay, hole option on the right side of the solid. Okay, very good, very good. But there is a trick to use that hole option. Now, how we will use that hole option? First of all, drag out the cylinder from the shapes corner. Drag out the cylinder and change its dimensions. Make it 10 and width of your cylinder as 10 and 10. Is it done? Change the length and the width of the cylinder to be 10 and 10 each. And height, you can make it as 40 only because we will be making a hole using this cylinder. Okay. Make its height as 40. and now click on the whole option from where we have chosen the color earlier. Your cylinder will look something like this. Is it done? Is it done, guys? Have you done this step? Have you made the cylinder? Okay. Now, the next thing is we have to rotate this cylinder. Okay, so to rotate your cylinder, first of all, you have to go to left view. First of all, go to the left view like this. Now we will see our cylinder from the left view. Move to the left view, and on the top of the cylinder, you can see these double-headed arrows. Click on the double-headed arrows and type 90 degree over here. Your cylinder will be in this position now. Move to left view, and then select the cylinder, and on the top of the cylinder, there will be these double-headed arrows, and from those double-headed arrows, type 90 degree over there. So your cylinder will be in this position now. Yeah, I am repeating myself. Okay, let me just repeat the cylinder part. Okay, let me just repeat it. Drag the cylinder, change its dimensions. Keep it as 10 and 10 and height as 40. Height as 40 and make it whole. Okay, make it whole. After that, move to the left view. And from the left view, click on these double-headed arrows and type 90 degree over here. Now your cylinder will be like this. Let's move on to the next part now. Now the next thing is I want this cylinder to fit inside this square box, but exactly in the center of this box or in this cube. So what I will do, I will select this box first, then press the shift key from your keyboard to select cylinder. So these two objects will be selected together now. Okay, select both the objects together. Now on the right hand side, there is an option to align. There is an option to align. Click on this align option. Now, when you will click on this align option, you will see some black color dots over here. Now, I want it to align it centrally. So first I will click on this center one black dot and then over here. Now my cylinder is fitting inside this box that is also in this exact center. Okay, I am repeating it once more. Let me just repeat it once more. Select both the objects together. Like first select the this box, then press the shift key to select the cylinder. After selecting both the objects together, click on this align option, and from align, click on this black dot first and then on this vertical side. Now your cylinder is perfectly fitting inside this box. After this, you have to click on group. You have to click on group that is also on the right hand side. When you will click on group, you will see there is a hole in your box right now. Is it done? Okay, take your time. It's on my screen only. Just repeat the steps which I have done. Okay. I am explaining it again. Select both the objects together. Let me just repeat the steps for you guys. Okay. Yeah. So click on the box. then press the shift key and select the cylinder. Now both of your objects are selected together. Now click on this align option. Click on this align option. And after clicking on align, press this center black dot over here. And then this black dot. Now your box is in the center. Now click on group. Now the hole is already in your this box. Done? Is it done? Group option is on the right hand side, where there is the option of align a C. When you will see from the right, there is mirror, then align, then ungroup, and then there is this group button. So when you will click on this group button, it will be making a hole in your square, this box. Now, what I have to do is, I have to take this box on my skateboard. So what I will do, I will select this box and using my arrow keys, I will move it to this square box. Okay. Like this, you have to move it to this square box. Now, if you will be finding that yeah, our box is like a little bit bigger than in the size than the square board, than the skateboard. So what we can do is we can change the size of our box to 10 and 10 and height also to 10. Okay, and fix it on the board like this. How to change the position of the cylinder. When you will select the cylinder, on the top of the cylinder, there will be a double-headed arrows. On those double-headed arrows, you will have to press, you have to click on those double-headed arrows and then type 90 degrees. Now, what I need is, I want one more box like this on the other side of the skateboard. So I will simply select this skateboard and then click on this duplicate and repeat button and move it on the right side using the arrow keys. So now I am having two boxes on my skateboard. How I have done this? Selected my this box which I have designed, then clicked on this duplicate and repeat command on the left hand side, and using the arrow keys I have moved it to the right hand side of the board. Now the next thing which we will be doing is we will be designing the wheels of our skateboard. So for designing the wheels, again we have to take a cylinder, bring the cylinder again. If you are not able to select them together, first select the first item, then press the shift key, then select the other object. Then both the objects will be selected together. To put it on the skateboard, select your box and move your arrow keys. And move the box using the arrow keys. Now, from this now we have taken the cylinder, change its height to 2. It will look something like this. And length and width also, change it to 10 and 10 each. Change the length and width of the wheel to 10 and 10 each. So height will be 2 and length and width will be 10 each. Okay. Now, again, you have to bring one more cylinder. Bring out one more cylinder and change its length to 5 and width also to 5. And height we will keep it as 25. Height we will keep it as 25. Then we have designed the wheel with the dimensions 10 and 10 and its width as 2. And then I have taken one more cylinder and I have kept its length and width as 5 and height as 25. Now, this bigger cylinder, move it up from the work plane using this black cone, and using the arrow keys, I will place it on the top of my wheel like this. You will have to move this, put this cylinder on the top of your wheel. I am repeating my steps again from this cylinder. I hope you got, all of you have designed the wheel. Now, take one more cylinder and change its dimensions. Change the dimension of the cylinder to 2.5 and wait a second, guys. Bring out the cylinder, change the dimensions to 2.5 and 2.5 and length as 25. Length as 25. Okay. Now select your this cylinder and place it on the top of your wheel. And we will again align it so that our box should be in the center. Sorry, this bigger cylinder should be in the center of the wheel. So I hope you guys know how to align it. After putting this long cylinder on this wheel, I will click on the align command and I will just simply align it centrally. Okay. Is it done? Is it done till this point? Have you guys designed this wheel and this long cylindrical bar? Okay. Now, after this, what we have to do is okay. What you guys want me to repeat? Which step? This wheel one? Okay, the whole part is okay. You want me to repeat the whole how I have designed the whole? Okay, wait. I will show you quickly how to design the whole. Take a box, okay, change its dimensions to 10, and height also to 10. Then take a cylinder. And change the dimensions of cylinder to 10 and height to 40. Then click on this hole option and from the left view, click on these double headed arrows and type 90 degrees like this. Okay, I am just showing you how to make a hole. Okay, you can adjust the dimensions accordingly. Now select this box and cylinder and then align them align them. Okay, and this way when you will group it, it will make a whole. I hope it is clear to you guys how to make a whole. Now I am moving forward to the design which we were doing. We have designed this wheel structure. Now I will select this wheel and click on this duplicate command again. And I will move it up from the work plane using this black cone. And I will place it over here like this. Okay, so we can, so this is the wheel which we will put inside the skateboard. I am repeating the wheel structure again. Okay, just I am repeating it again. Take a cylinder, change its dimensions to 5. Each, change its dimensions to 5 each, and height we will keep it as 20, or let's make it 25. Okay, make it 2.5 and 2.5. Sorry, I just forgot. Make it 2.5 and 2.5. Take a cylinder, change its length and breadth to 2.5 and 2.5. And height to 25. Okay. Now take the cylinder again. Take the cylinder again and change its dimensions to 10 and 10 and height to be 2.5. Is it done? Is it done, guys, till this point? Okay, now select this cylindrical bar and move it with your arrow keys. And we will place it in the center of this this wheel by using the align command. I will select both these objects and align them. Like this. Okay. So I have designed it again for you guys. Now select this bottom wheel and click on this duplicate and repeat command. And using the this cone over here, we will just move it on the top of this cylindrical bar. Now we have designed this wheel structure. Now I will simply select this whole design and click on group and will change its color to black. Now I have got this this wheel structure. Now I will just simply go to left view and then again I will make it turn to 90 degrees. Now using the arrow keys, I will put it inside the hole which we have created in that box. Like this. Okay, it is still outside the box, so I will just. Using the arrow keys, you have to fit it inside the box. Okay, like this. Okay, don't worry guys, if you are not able to design it, we will share the video so you can just follow the steps to make it. Okay, now what I need is I want the same wheel on the other side of my design also. Like we can't just move with the two pairs of one pair of wheels only. We need two pair of wheels. So I will select this pair of wheels and again duplicate it, and using the arrow keys I will move it towards here. I have got the wheels on both sides. Now the thing is, now we have to group whole design together. If I will click on group, you might see the colors, all the colors will change to one color, but we have designed it differently. So what I will do, I will click on this sound color option, and then I will click on this multicolor, and now my skateboard is looking differently with all the parts of my skateboard are of different colors. Now we have to rotate it again. I will click on it again from the left hand side, and on these double headed arrows I will just type 90 degrees. Okay, so 90 degrees, make it align, like make it stand like this. So what we will do, we will make it move more towards like 90 degrees. Now it is perfectly aligned on the ground, and my skateboard is also ready. Like, what one more thing is, like with this 3D designing, you can also print your 3D designs. Like if, like we print the text on the paper using the printer, like 2D things we can print, you can also print the 3D things also. Okay, so this is the design of the skateboard. And if you are having any doubt in any part, like you can ask me now which part you want me to show you how to design it. I will just quickly show you how to design that part. You can post your query in the chat box. Skateboard. Okay, you want me to show the design of the skateboard. Okay, I will quickly just show you how to design it. So those...
Guys, like you may be tension free. I have prepared a doc file for you with all the instructions step by step. I'll be attaching those files on the chat. It's a doc file. It's step one, you need to do this. Step two, you need to do this. So step by step, along with the images, I have prepared a doc file for you. I'm just attaching it. Please download them. Two files will be there, one for the maze game and one for the skateboard.
Okay, so
just give me a sec, I'm attaching it. Yeah, Sarabjot, you may continue.
Okay, so see guys, you will get the doc file. So like if anything which you have missed during the session, you can go through that doc file and you will get the solution to that. Now someone is saying Control plus G did not work. To make it work, you first you have to select the design. Okay, let me just show you how to group it. Like I have this taken this box. Let me, I'm just drawing something randomly, and this is a box over here, cylindrical shape. I will just increase the height. Now I want to group these things together. So what I will do, first I will select the cylinder, press the shift key, then select the box. Now both the both the objects are selected. Now your control G will work. Control plus G will work. Okay. Now I will click on this group. Now my both the objects are together. Now this is showing like both the objects are having same color. So this is showing that they are grouped together. Now group means that whenever I will move them, so both will move together. Like if they will be ungrouped, so we will be able to move them differently. You can also make them multicolor from this option. So now they are multicolor but still grouped. Okay. Guys, you can check the the doc file in the chat box. You can download the that doc file from the chat box of maze game as well as skateboard. There is complete solution to this. You will find the complete step by step with the images also. Any other query, you can ask me. If you are having any other query, so you can ask.
So Sarabjot, if you may stop your screen share, I need to make an announcement, guys.
Yeah, sure. I'm just stopping my screen.
Don't worry of this video. This video will be uploaded on the YouTube and the link will be shared with you. You can go through this class again. So no need to worry. Nothing will be missed. And the doc files are there with you on the chat. Please download them. Okay. Now I want to just ask one thing, that have you guys enjoyed the session? Have you guys enjoyed? Might be few of you didn't completed your project. We can understand that because of this much gathering, it might be the issue. But everything, all the resources will be shared with you. So don't worry. Might be by the end of today, you will be getting everything. Okay? All right. Have you enjoyed the platform otherwise? Tinkercad and PictoBlocks, both were handy for you. Have you guys enjoyed the session? All right, now I'm sharing my screen. There is an announcement for you guys. You guys may leave your softwares and come here on Zoom. You may turn on your video, everyone. Okay, you may say there is a gift for you. I want to give you something. I hope my screen is visible to all. Yeah, is the screen visible? Okay. So guys, please listen carefully, whatever I'm now telling you. So this is our website, goglobalways.com. You may visit after the class. This is our website, goglobalways.com. And on this, several courses are there. Age-appropriate courses are there. And I want to give you a free course. Right, on that will be on PictoBlocks. Okay, chapters will be there in that, assignments will be there, quizzes will be there. You need to complete that. Around 8 chapters are there in that. Okay, let me show you how the course will look like. How to access the course, that will be shared to you. You will be getting the username and password. You will be getting username and password. Using those user credentials, you will be logging on our website, goglobalways.com. And this is the course that you will be getting. It is a basic game design course. The name of the course is Go Gamer. In this, 8 chapters are there. Like this, the course will look like to you. So 8 chapters are there, games are there, stories, assignments you need to upload, one you need to perform it on PictoBlocks. Each and every step is given. Like for example, making a walking animation, I'm opening that chapter, making a walking animation. So if you open it, this how the chapter will look like. There is a small video, what exactly needs to be done in the chapter, and step by step instructions are there. You need to make your sprite move, walk. So you will choose a backdrop, you will choose a sprite, choose a starting position from where it will start. Each and every block explanation is there, what exactly you need to make in the end. So this will be your output. Then you need to save your project, and here you need to upload that assignment. Okay, after uploading, there is a small quiz, then you can go to the next chapter. You won't be able to skip anything in between. All the chapters you need to perform in sequence. After completing chapter 1, you will go to chapter 2, then 3, then 4, like that in sequence you need to do. I hope I am clear, right? So each and every explanation is there. So you guys may attempt this course. You will get the basic understanding of PictoBlocks, how to design games, how to design stories. Those who are beginner, they can start learning from here. And those who have done already, you guys can also do and revise your concepts. Okay? I have received a few forms. You might have filled the forms, right? I have your email ID. I will be adding all of you on this so that you can get the access. You will be getting your username and password on the email ID with which you are registered. You have filled the form. In that email ID we have received, you will be getting the access in that. So don't worry how to open it and how to use it. You will be getting everything in the email, step-by-step instructions. It was just an announcement. All right. Am I left with anything? Anything unclear? You guys can ask. It is not compulsory to do, but it will be good if you practice. Just utilize your lockdown in this way. It's not compulsory to do.
Ma'am?
Just a free course for you. So,
Kritika, I would like to take one group picture of course, gallery.
Of course.
Yeah, so please, children, if all of you can turn on your videos. Vedant, can you please also turn on your video? Kritika, do you want to share something along with this?
I guess I am done. Like, I have shared everything.
Okay.
Ma'am, you have not shared the doc file in the chat.
I shared the doc file. Like, you scroll the chats up, you will get. I'm attaching it again. Don't worry. I'm attaching it again.
Yeah. Any screen share you want? Kritika, dear, any Go Global logo or something like this? Anything along with
yeah,
this?
Yeah, sure. I may share the website.
Yeah.
How to what?
I'm signing.
Yeah, sign. That's what I'm saying. On the email ID, you will be getting the username and password. So don't worry. You will get everything.
Ma'am, on our Mount Carmel ID.
Yeah, on Mount Carmel ID, you will get.
Children, please stop chatting for 2 minutes so that I can take the pics. Okay, dear. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, everyone.
Enjoyed. Yes, children. New things you have learned.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
The 3D animation was so interesting.
Ma'am.
So now want you to create your innovative projects in that. Okay. Using PictoBlocks and using Tinkercad 3D animations. Right? You're going to explore yourself many things in that and make. Okay, dear? Thank you, kids, for being so patient. Yeah, we really had a wonderful session. I really thank Kritika, Sarbjot, and Go Global team for this wonderful, interesting, knowledgeable session on behalf of Mount Carmel School. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Pam, for arranging this session.
Ma'am, as this session was very awesome.
Thank you so much, guys, for the feedback.
Thank you so much.
Means a lot. I shared the doc file again, right? Please download them and follow the instructions again. If something is missed in the class, you can have a quick recap. Please download those files. They are doc so that anyone can use. I have not attached the MictoBlocks file directly or STL file of Tinkercad. I have shared the step-by-step instruction instead.
And the session was amazing.
Thank you so much. Even the audience is amazing. That's why the session went very well.
Thank you, session was amazing.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Was fun.
Thank you so much, guys. The audience is amazing, in fact.
Thank you, ma'am.
The session was amazing. Thank you so much, guys. Now you guys may have breakfast. There is so much of like...
Yeah,
we have spoiled your morning.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Please ask. Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, guys.
Bye, ma'am.
Have a nice day, ma'am.
Have a nice day to you too.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Okay. Will you
please show us an AI? Yeah, sure, we will be. Everything will be shared with you.
Okay, ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Can you share the docs in the WhatsApp?
I don't have your WhatsApp number, actually.
Okay.
It's easy to download from the Zoom chat, guys. Just click on that button. Click to download. It will be downloaded.
We cannot find anything on Zoom chat.
I shared twice, actually. Let me share it again.
I have gone through the whole chat once.
Okay, I'm attaching it again. Actually, there are so many chats you might not be able to find. I'm attaching it again. Sure. It's done from my side.
I even downloaded it.
Perfect.
Beta, move towards the end and then you will find these two again.
And next year, on next Wednesday.
Okay, next class next Wednesday. Sure, we'll try to arrange something else. Okay, guys, bye bye then. Shall I end the session? Yes. Have you guys downloaded the file?
Yes, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Have a nice day and do practice whatever we have learned.
Okay, ma'am.
Bye-bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Okay, bye, dear.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye-bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye.